I will say Christ in me. That's what I want to talk about briefly. It's a message God gave to me. Christ in me. Can you say Christ in me? Just one scripture and we'll round up. In 1 John chapter 4 and verse 4. 1 John chapter 4 and verse 4 is my popular scripture and I want to just read it for you. Can we all read together? Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. There's a colon after overcome them. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The first major statement here, there are a few major statements made here. The first one is, ye are of God. I will say, I am of God. Ye are of God. He's talking to those who are born again. When you become born again, you are of God. You are no longer of yourself. When we say something is of God, that means you belong to God. Everybody say, I belong to God. You are not just yourself. You belong to, you are not the owner of yourself. You are of God. You belong to God. You know when the Bible says in Romans 5:5, the love of God is shed abroad in your heart. Everybody say, the love of God. Not your love. Which one? The love of God. They don't say, you are of God. You are no longer yourself. You belong to God. God owns you. If you say the love of God, that means the love from God, the love that is of God, is in you. The love of God is shed abroad in your heart. The love of God is shed abroad in your heart. You may not know it, but it's in your heart. And how do we know? And that is why the love of God in your heart is derived from your love for God. Did you hear what I said? The love of God in your heart shows God put his love in you. Your love for God shows that you show love towards God. You can have the love of God in your heart, but you don't show it. You don't have love for God. Everybody say, love for God. Love for God is derived from love of God. Are you hearing me? Love for God. If my love for you will cause me to do things to advance your life. So when you have love for God, you do things to advance the kingdom of God. Now, you are of God. That means you belong to God. Little children. That means we are children of God. Everybody say, I'm a child of God. He said, you are of God, little children, and have overcome them. You have what? Overcome them. Can I hear you say, I am an overcomer? You have overcome them. The Bible says in 1 John 5 verse 4, whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. So you are born of God. The Bible says you have overcome them. You are an overcomer. You are of God, little children, have overcome them. You have overcome what? You overcome the world. What is the world? The system of the world. You have overcome sin. Amen. In Christ, there is no sin. He that commits sin is of the devil. You are no more of the devil. You are of God. There are people here who have drunk alcohol before. But since they became born again, they have overcome alcohol. I mean, you can't even think of it. They can't even imagine it. They have overcome them. You have overcome alcohol. It's the same way you should overcome everything of the world. Ye are of God. You have overcome them. You have overcome the evils of the world. You have overcome witches and wizards. You have overcome sorcerers and sorceress. You have overcome all the occultists and satanists. You have overcome the armed robbers, kidnappers, killers, and assassins. That's why we said the day you're on the way, they will not be on the way. We are saying it emphatically. It shall be so in the name of Jesus Christ. Let it dwell in your spirit that you have overcome them. You have overcome sicknesses and diseases. Whether coronavirus, What is the new variant now? Omicron. It will never come to Jos. In the name of Jesus Christ. And if you go anywhere because you have overcome them, it will not near you. Praise the name of the Lord. He said you have overcome them. Not that you will overcome. You have already overcome. I went somewhere that day and everybody was wearing, covering their nose and their mouth. And I was the only one not covering. I was feeling guilty. I searched my Bible whether I have one to fulfill all righteousness. I wasn't having. I said, what do I do now? And they still allow me to sit down. So I was sitting down feeling guilty that I didn't wear the thing they wear. Not because I'm not wearing it because I'm afraid of corona and all those things. I wear it to fulfill all righteousness. Because God may say, wear. I said, okay, let me just wear to glorify, to fulfill all righteousness. But I believe I've overcome them. Are you hearing me? You will never suffer of any terminal disease in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. I'm not saying you should not take caution. I'm just telling you, you have overcome sicknesses and diseases. They brought a young man here. They said he was looking for 1.9 million to take him to India for healing. And they brought him here. It was our choir leader that brought him to me here. I lay hands on him and say, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke everything that is wrong with your kidney. The whole thing changed. He stood here and gave you testimony in this church. How God healed him of what he needed to have gone to India for with 1.9 million. If it is now 1.9 million, it should be going to about 5 or 6 million now. Everybody say, I have overcome them. You have overcome sicknesses. You have overcome diseases. You have overcome pains. You have overcome every evil. You have overcome them. You have overcome the word divorce. Nothing like, how can a believer talk of divorce? Everybody say, I have overcome. Speak Igbo, say tufiakwa. What is the meaning of tufiakwa? God forbid. Even Paul said it. Paul said tufiakwa. Hope you know, sir, about two or three places, Paul said tufiakwa. He said, God forbid. He said, do we continue in sin that grace may abound? And what did Paul say in Igbo? Tufiakwa. Paul is an Igbo man. You know, he said, I'm of the Hebrew tribe, of the Benjamin tribe, a Hebrew of Hebrews. That's what he called himself. And I've had Igbos in Nigeria saying they are originally from Hebrew. From his Hebrew, they turn to Hebrew. It even called Hebrew. Hallelujah. Lift up your eyes and say, I'm an overcomer. God said you have overcome. You have overcome divorce, separation. You have overcome your children going useless. You see them die. If your child is misbehaving, hey, come here. Sit down here. Mosketo pondali karuta bazudia. God gave you to me. You can't behave like this. I've overcome wickedness of my children. In the name of Jesus. If the child can't do that, allow the child to sleep. While the child is sleeping, you go there and lay hands on the child and speak in tongue. Konto ponto lobando. If the locked door, you lay hands on the door. The child, the prayer will change immediately. Are you hearing me? God cannot give you children to trouble you. The blessing of the Lord maketh rich and added no sorrow. God never gave you children to trouble you. From today, every child troubling you, I command the trouble to be over. As every child that is taking away your peace, I command that trouble to be over. I am telling you what is happening here. There is somebody here. Your children are not giving you peace. You are not excited about what they are doing. But God is arresting those children so that they bring peace unto you in Jesus' name. You have overcome them. And you that is troubling your children, I mean your parents, I rebuke that trouble in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, honor your father and your mother, that it might be well with you, that the number of your days might be fulfilled. You have overcome poverty. Some call it poverty, whichever way you pronounce it. Everybody say, I've overcome it. Your father is blessed. God wants you to be mightily blessed financially. He said you have overcome them. You have overcome foolishness. You have overcome idiosyncrasy of any kind. You have overcome failure. Everybody say, we know they fail. I saw a good result again recently. Powerful results that excited me. And the lady said, you know, say we know the faith. This is my result. I took first position. I said, wonderful. Wonderful. Come on. When I on Sunday, come and see me. I will give you a prize. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You have overcome failure. You are not destined to fail. You have overcome evil attack. You have overcome lack of this, lack of that, lack of that. He said, ye of God, little children, and have overcome them. Now, look at the main cross of the message as we round up. He said in the next part of that scripture, 1 John 4 verse 4, he said, 4 verse 4. Ye are of God, little children. Verse 4, please. Back to verse 4. And I've overcome them. Can you see the full colon there? He said, he's telling you that because of this statement I made, this will happen. This is why it will happen. Everyone say, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Who is he that is in you? Everyone say, Christ in me, the hope of glory. In Colossians 1 verse 27, that's what the Bible says. Christ in me, the hope of glory. This Christ that is in you. In the Old Testament, Christ was not in us. He was with us. He was Emmanuel. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He was what? Emmanuel. Emmanuel means what? God with us. Everybody say with us. If somebody is with you and somebody is in you, hope you know which one is deeper. Huh? In you. If a demon come and oppress you, that means he's not inside you. He's just attacking you. Maybe he's talking to your ear. He said, go and say that thing. Go and say that thing. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. But if the demon possesses you, he will be, instead of oppressing, he's possessing you. It will be in you. Now, Christ is with us, but he's not just with us. He's in us. Everybody say, Christ in us. Can you hear that? Which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Christ is not just with us. But when we are together collectively like this, Christ is with us. Is that clear? But beyond that, when you are a Christian, he said, we are two or three. There I am with them. Is that what he says? He's with us when we are collectively together like that. But personal relationship with God is that Christ is in you. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. So you see, it's beyond just God being our Emmanuel. But it goes all to the point that Christ is now in us. Everybody say, Christ in me. He said, because you greater is he that is in you. That is why you become an overcomer. What makes you an overcomer is that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The devil is in the world. Christ is in you. The devil is in the world. Christ in you. The one in you is greater than the devil that is in the world. So why should you fear the one that is in the world when the greater one is in you? Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. That's why when I do crusade, when I go anywhere, I go with that consciousness that Christ is, where is he? In me. And that makes me an overcomer. If what I just said is done on you, you know it as you know your name. So many issues are settled in your life. Are you hearing me? So many issues are settled in your life. Christ in me. Many people don't believe Christ is in them. And if you don't believe that, then you are suffering from unbelief. And unbelief will never give you a miracle. But if you believe Christ is in you, oh, that settles it. Praise the name of the Lord. So that is what makes you an overcomer. Is that clear? Can we finalize it? Okay. Colossians 1:27 made us to believe it. They that are of the world, therefore speak. Just go back to verse 4. We don't have that time for verse 5 now. Ye of God, little children, you have overcome them. Why? Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The devil is in the world, but the one in you makes you an overcomer. How many of you believe by this scripture you are going home today as an overcomer? Hallelujah. Remember, it begins with your salvation. It begins with your what? Salvation. Ye are of God. The moment you become born again, you are of God. And once you are of God, then of course, the greater one. He said you have already overcome them. Why? For the greater one, the Lord himself, is in you. Christ in you is the hope of glory. So you enjoy the glory of God, the beauty of God, the goodness of God is what we call the glory of God. Psalm 84 verse 11, which our scripture for the year. May the Lord help us to keep recognizing that Christ is in us. It's not just with us, he's in us. He's with us, he's also in us. Just like when you get baptized in the Holy Spirit, when you got born again, the Spirit of God came in the inside of you. Christ in you. And when you get baptized in the Holy Spirit, it's not just in you, it's also on you. Filled with the Holy Ghost. Is a president, it takes residence in your life and it becomes the president of your life. That is whom Jesus is to us. So sometimes why we don't emphasize so much of it about Emmanuel is that beyond just he being Emmanuel, the greater part of it is that Christ is where? He's in us. He's in us.